My name is Dr. Seema Shah Fairbank, and in this video you'll be introduced to various gradually varied flow profiles for specific channel types. These channel types include mild, steep, critical, horizontal, and adverse channels. For each channel type, there are various water surface profiles that are formed based on a specific flow regime, subcritical, critical, and supercritical flow, and channel control, upstream or downstream. The following provides example of hydraulic structures that will cause the water surface that we will discuss in this video to occur. The Hoover Dam provides an example of what we call backwater profiling. Backwatering occurs when flows are ponded on the downstream side. The Hoover Dam is located at the border of Nevada and Arizona on the Colorado River. A waterfall effect causes the flows to go through critical. Flows upstream of the waterfall are under subcritical flow, causing the water to go under drawdown conditions. A weir, such as this V-notch weir, causes flows to go through critical depth prior to the flows entering the downstream section. Upstream of the weir, the flows are subcritical, causing a drawdown effect. A sluice gate, as shown in this image, will cause the water upstream of the gate to be subcritical, and the flows downstream of the gate to be supercritical. The subcritical flows on the upstream side result in a backwater effect, while on the downstream side, we will have supercritical flows with an upstream control of the sluice gate itself, resulting in flows below critical depth. The first channel type to discuss is a mild channel, where the normal depth is greater than the critical depth. An M1 profile is formed in zone 1, where the flow regime is subcritical. By definition, a subcritical flow occurs when the actual depth is greater than the critical depth. Flows that are subcritical are always controlled downstream. For an M1 profile, this is a result of a hydraulic structure that causes backwater, such as a dam. An M2 profile is formed in zone 2, when the flow regime is subcritical. As before, a subcritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is greater than the critical depth. Flows that are subcritical are always controlled downstream. For an M2 profile to occur, there needs to be critical depth control at the downstream location. This will occur when there is a slope change or a waterfall. An M3 profile is formed in zone 3, where the flow regime is supercritical. A supercritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is less than the critical depth. Flows that are supercritical are always controlled upstream. For an M3 profile to occur, there needs to be something upstream causing the water surface to be below critical depth. This will occur when there is a slope change or a sluice gate. The second profile type is a steep channel, where the normal depth is less than the critical depth. An S1 profile is formed in zone 1, when the flow regime is subcritical. By definition, a subcritical flow occurs when the actual depth is greater than the critical depth. Flows that are subcritical are always controlled downstream. For an S1 profile, this is the result of a hydraulic structure, such as a dam, creating backwater. An S2 profile is formed in zone 2, where the flow regime is supercritical since the water surface is less than critical depth. A subcritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is less than critical depth. Flows that are supercritical are always controlled upstream. For an S2 profile to occur, there needs to be critical depth control on the upstream side. The most common occurrence for an S2 profile is a slope change. An S3 profile is formed in zone 3 when the flow regime is supercritical. As before, a supercritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is less than the critical depth. Flows that are supercritical are always controlled upstream. For an S3 profile to occur, there needs to be something upstream causing the water surface to be below critical. This will occur when there is a slope change or a sluice gate. The third channel type is a critical channel, where the normal depth is equal to the critical depth. A C1 profile is formed in zone 1, when the flow regime is subcritical. By definition, a subcritical channel flow condition occurs when the actual depth is greater than the critical depth. Flows that are subcritical are always controlled downstream. For a C1 profile. For a C1 profile, this is the result of a hydraulic structure that causes backwater, such as a dam. There is no zone 2 in critical channels. This is because DN is equal to DC. A C3 profile is formed in zone 3 when the flow regime is supercritical. As prior, channels that are supercritical occur when the actual depth is less than the critical depth. Flows that are supercritical are always controlled upstream. For a C3 profile to occur, there needs to be something upstream causing the water surface to be below critical. This will occur when there is a slope change or a sluice gate. The fourth channel type is a horizontal channel, where the normal depth cannot be determined because the slope that is included in the Manning's equation is zero. Please note that rivers will have segments that are horizontal. However, the Froude number can be calculated since it is not a function of slope, and the critical depth will be calculated. There is no zone 1 since normal depth cannot be determined. An H2 profile is formed in zone 2 when the flow regime is subcritical. As before, a subcritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is greater than the critical depth. Flows that are subcritical are always controlled downstream. For an H2 profile to occur, there needs to be critical depth control at the downstream location. This will occur when there is a slope change or a waterfall. An H3 profile is formed in zone 3. When the flow regime is supercritical. A supercritical channel occurs when the actual depth is less than the critical depth. Flows that are supercritical are always controlled upstream. And for an H3 profile to occur, there needs to be something causing the water surface to go below critical. This will occur when there is a slope change or a sluice gate. The fifth and final channel type is an adverse channel. An adverse channel has a negative slope. This results in an inability to calculate the normal depth. If you're unable to calculate a normal depth, no profiles can be formed in zone 1. An A2 profile is formed in zone 2, where the flow regime is subcritical. As before, A subcritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is greater than the critical depth. Flows that are subcritical are always controlled downstream. For an A2 profile to occur, there needs to be critical depth control at the downstream location. This will occur when there is a slope change or waterfall. An A3 profile and our final profile is formed in zone 3, where the flow regime is supercritical. A supercritical flow condition occurs when the actual depth is less than the critical depth. Flows that are supercritical are always controlled upstream, and for an A3 profile to occur, there needs to be something upstream causing the water surface to go below critical. This will occur when there is a slope change. Over the past several years, I have been working with Cal Poly Pomona's e-learning team to develop a learning object that can help students better identify different channel types. The following website will allow you to practice calculating critical depth, normal depth, identifying a water surface elevation or a control, and then determining what kind of water surface profile has been formed. Over the next several weeks, I would like you to practice utilizing this tool because it will help you further understand open channel flow, gradually varied flow profiles. Thank you very much for taking the time to participate in this video. You have now learned the various water surface profiles that can be formed in mild, steep, critical, horizontal, and adverse channels based on channel control and flow regime. For further questions and assistance, follow my channel to help you better understand open channel hydraulics.